Russ, just some of the emotions. Third win in a week, four in a row. You must be thrilled with all that.
Yeah, I think we're too tired to feel anything, Mitch, I think, at the minute. I'm immensely proud of the players, the staff, the fans, the amount they've travelled this week. To get the 3 wins is an incredible return. I think if anyone had said at the start of the week we'd get 9 points, I think we'd probably be the only people that would believe we would be capable of that. Incredible. They've shown immense courage, energy, but the last two games certainly showed today, I think, in the second half. We started the game with brilliant energy, so aggressive, maybe could have scored one or two more. Their goalkeeper made a couple of brilliant saves, looked a threat, but we just couldn't sustain that energy. And it started creeping in the last 15 minutes of the first half. They flew down yesterday. They played on Tuesday. It's very different. We spent a long, long time on the bus this week. We got back to the stadium here on Thursday morning at 3:30 with a really young group. It's not easy. So I think that showed. That showed for sure. So the second half was a bit more painful, and I don't think we're overly satisfied with probably the performance for, apart from the first half an hour. But we've been in here so many times this season where the performance has been, we've been really satisfied with it, and the result hasn't reflected that. So it's nice to be happier about the result than the performance today. But I still thought we had some brilliant moments in the second half. When Olivier come on and we changed Joel's position a little bit, we started showing a bit more courage and a bit more intensity on the ball, and it created some really nice openings for us. We just couldn't quite kill the game off. Their goalkeepers made more saves than Stephen. They had a lot of the ball in the second half, and they're a really good team, by the way. I really like them, Sunderland. The way they play, Alex Pritchard, didn't enjoy watching him today, but I've played with him, and he's an excellent player. They've got some really good players, and they'll cause a lot of teams problems this year with the energy they have. So energy was a huge factor in the second half. But the lads showed huge resilience, togetherness, determination, desire to protect what we had. The goals were really poor ones to concede. I'm annoyed about that. I think the players will be as well and watch it back. But we've won 4 games in a row in this league, which is with the young group that we have as well. Learning, and after the start we had to the season, that's no mean feat. So really, really proud of them for that. And I'm sure once we get the performance out of the way and we dust it, we have a look at it and we've reflect on it and learn from it, we'll make sure that if we're in that position again, the second half's a bit easier than it was today. But I think it's down to how many miles we travelled, and I feel knackered. Gillett, like with the coaching staff, are absolutely knackered. So I dread to think how the players feel. It's been a really long week. But a brilliant one.
Yeah, and in terms of the changes, 4 from the game at Watford, Harry Darling was one of those who came in, and you know that sort of depth has really served you well this week particularly. But you know, how pleasing are you for him to come in, play the way he did, particularly in that first half, and get a goal as well?
Really pleased for H. He's had to be patient because Woody and Ben have been outstanding. Same with Kyle in between them, who helps us so much with so many aspects of the game, especially the young guys either side of him. So yeah, really pleased for H. He's had to be really patient. I think the most pleasing bit with Harry today was how he defended the box in the second half, blocks, defending really robustly. And some people, it just takes a bit longer to adapt to a different environment, different level, but he's going to be, listen, we didn't try so hard to get him in the summer. We know what he's going to be. We know what he is capable of. But Woody and Ben have just been really, really top, so it's been really difficult for him. But yeah, brilliant performance, really pleased for him to score. We looked a real threat from set pieces today. Massive credit to Andy Parslow and the work he puts into the players. I think it's the same with anything. We try and put so much detail into the guys, it takes some time, and Andy's the same. They've had a lot of detail, had to listen to a lot. It's starting to finally really pay off. And the mentality of the players now, I think you see them running up to a set piece, they feel confident they're going to get a chance from it. Ben Cabango in particular, the aggression he shows. So, really, really pleased for Harry and the guys that came in. We needed their energy. We needed Lats, what I thought was his first game in however long, was fantastic, really outstanding. So much ease, how much he's come on and improved as a player in the last year has been incredible to watch. Is the best part about our job, really, seeing those guys, how much they can improve and how brave they are. So, and Luke and Ollie had real moments, but then the game was so intense, they'd used all their energy up, so we had to make a couple of changes. So, and that's spoke about it in the dressing room. The subs, the people who've been on the bench and come out, played a huge part in the impact they've had in the last three games in particular. So, we have to remain that way, and everyone needs to be really competing for places, and it's nice to have a bit of that now.
you mentioned Andy Parslow there, that's three set piece goals this week alone. That's more than he had in the whole of the league last season. He's certainly moving his crust at the moment.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? This, we were looking for something different this summer. Obviously, we brought Chris up. Chris O'Leary's been brilliant, so good for us. Gilly, obviously, is brilliant. I wouldn't want to do it with anyone else. And then Chris has just come on and added a nice dimension. Understands the club, the supporters, is a huge fan of the club, cares so much, brilliant. The young players have a great relationship with him, that have come through the 21s in the academy already. And then so we looked for something a bit different, sort of what was a real weakness for us last year, and it was definitely that. So he's definitely shored us up. Set piece, the amount of detail he goes into, and it's not easy, and it's not always enjoyable working on set pieces. So he's done brilliant with it, and the players, you know, real credit to them, because they bounce off each other now. And I think they're starting to enjoy the rewards.
Yeah, just lastly from me, a word on Ollie Cooper as well. Finally got the goal that was probably been coming for a while, in fairness to him.
Yeah, I'm pleased for Ollie. I think that will help him in the, you know, hopefully it will open up more, because he's had some really good chances. But he was great. He looked tired. Again, he hasn't played on Wednesday, but he played in the toughest games of his career so far, no doubt. West Brom away. It's been a real baptism of fire for him from where he was last season and what he's faced so far this season. He came on and had a brilliant impact on Wednesday night, and then today he looked a little bit tired, that's why he came off, but even then he's had a huge impact on the game. The fans really enjoy watching him, we do, the players really trust him, and he's got to keep now that, like we said before, the biggest challenge for him now is to remain in the team and to make sure he's competitive, because he has some really excellent players competing for a place for him. So he's done great, and hopefully that goal will do him a world of good.
You're 3 points off the top of the table now, Russell. I mean, when you look at that, it must look very open all of a sudden, very inviting.
I haven't looked at it yet, so I'm sure we'll over the weekend. But, Graham, I think it just focuses on us, really, mate, in the process, and just try to improve. We need to improve on today. We need to improve on today for sure for next week. But I think we have a lot of reasons we feel the performance wasn't quite there in the second half. But the league is wide open, you know. I'm just really proud that the players have put themselves in this position after the start that we had. So if you'd have said that after five or six games we'd be sitting like this now, that's taken huge effort from everyone, the staff, the players, the supporters to stick with it. The energy they gave the team in the last 10 minutes today was brilliant. I think they could sense the team needed a bit of energy. So I think we're in a good place. We're in a good place, got a lot of young men who will keep improving for sure. And now the challenge for us is to remain consistent and to try and keep being relentless with the players and with what we do, and trying to keep carrying on this run, which is, as I said, not easy.
Russell, has the last week shown maybe the improvement in the side? Obviously not just the fact you've won three games, but you were conceding a lot of late goals. You had late drama at West Brom, right side of it. You scored an injury time goal at Watford. And today, obviously, second half, they were maybe the stronger team, but you managed the game really, really well. Is that pleasing for you after earlier?
Yeah, definitely. I think last season it was the opposite. We had a problem with at the start of games when teams had real energy and intensity. I think this season we scored the most goals in the opening 15 or 20 minutes of the in the league. So that's brilliant. They learnt a lot from that. We talked a lot through different strategies, what they're comfortable with, and they have a big say in what they're doing, the players, because they're on the pitch and living it. So we spoke again about this and the late goals, because we are, you know, talking about that in the position we're in now, we're still frustrated we haven't got more points. I feel like we should have, with the late goals that we conceded and stuff. And the players have used that frustration to drive them on. But I think they have definitely learning. You can see that. They're learning all the time. And sometimes it takes mistakes. You have to experience certain things on the pitch to learn. That's the harsh reality of football and life, that sometimes you have to experience a bit of pain to understand what it takes and to learn. So, hopefully we can continue with that as well. Right, I'm going to bed. See you later.